Lancashire police receive dozens of racism complaints with not a single one upheld. Lancashire Constabulary was among 12 forces that did not uphold a single complaint about racially motivated misconduct. Lancashire police have received dozens of allegations of racism by their staff over the last 5 years, but not one of them has been upheld. New data shows that 85 police officers and staff had been investigated in Lancashire between 2015 and 2028, but not one faced disciplinary action. Campaigners have called for allegations to be reinvestigated after the figures were branded disgusting and forces were accused of gaslighting victims of discrimination. The figures have revealed shocking discrepancies in the way different police forces deal with allegations of racism by their staff. Across England and Wales, 5,169 allegations of racially motivated misconduct were made to 39 police forces between 2015 and 2028, but just 153 were upheld, less than 3%. And huge gaps are evident between individual forces, with one upholding nearly half of complaints while 12 others did not uphold a single one. The Met Police received the highest number of complaints but dismissed 98.4% of the 1,368 allegations made against its staff. By comparison, Cheshire Police upheld 46.5% of its 43 complaints, while Northamptonshire's figure was 37.5% and in the West Midlands it was 31.6%. Lancashire Constabulary was among 12 forces that did not uphold a single complaint about racially motivated misconduct. A spokesperson for the force said, "As a police service, we are committed to upholding the highest standards of professional behavior. Each and every member of staff working for Lancashire Constabulary is clear about the standards of professional behavior in the Code of Ethics. And this applies to their conduct both on duty and off duty. The Constabulary strives to do our absolute best for the communities of Lancashire and to keep the public safe. We don't always get it right, and there will be occasions when members of the public feel that they've not been given the high level of service they rightly deserve and should expect. When this does happen, we would encourage our communities to tell us. This way we can ensure their complaint is recorded and we can try to find a solution or conduct a fair and proportionate investigation. The majority of complaints are dealt with by the Constabulary's Professional Standards Department. Each and every complaint is recorded and assessed and a determination made as to the most appropriate way of trying to resolve or investigate the issue. A small number of complaints are dealt with by the Independent Office for Police Conduct, IOPC, and this is usually because we have referred the matter to them. If a complainant feels unhappy with the outcome of their complaint, they do have a right of appeal to the Office of the Police and Crime Commissioner, OPCC, or in some cases to the IOPC. The vast majority of our staff work tirelessly each and every day to serve the communities of Lancashire, and we are grateful for the public support, trust, and confidence in us. If you are unhappy with the level of service you have received, please do tell us and give us the opportunity to address your concerns, to learn and to improve. The easiest way of doing this is via our website. This gives you all the detail on how to say thanks or make a complaint. Also included on the list were Cambridgeshire, Devon and Cornwall, Sussex, Hampshire, Thames Valley, Staffordshire, West Mercia, City of London, Gwent, Humberside and Cumbria. Three forces have not responded, Durham, Lincolnshire, and South Wales, while one, Wiltshire, refused to provide figures. Campaigners have branded the findings disgusting, saying they undermine confidence in UK policing. But the National Police Chiefs Council claims a variation is expected and denied institutional racism. Katrina French, chief executive of Stopwatch, which campaigns to make police more accountable, said the figures highlight a toxic culture within the UK's law enforcement. Katrina who said she had been made to undergo a strip search herself by police after being wrongly accused of having a weapon 5 years ago, said, "There's no accountability. This leaves people feeling marginalized. If you can't trust the police, who can you trust? The complaints process isn't fit for purpose." Ms. French said chief constables should go back and reinvestigate previous allegations. "It's clear that these shouldn't be investigated in-house," she stated. She said victims of police discrimination are being gaslighted and many are unwilling to go through the complaints process for fear of being targeted. Ms. French stated, "These complaints aren't malicious. It's a long and complex process which is very traumatic to relive. But most people won't complain to a system that they don't think they will get justice from. The state always wins. But I tell people that they need to make a complaint so that it's there on record." In a small number of cases, the figures reveal police staff were sacked for sickening discrimination. Campaigners say these cases are the tip of the iceberg, however. Adam Almeida from anti-racism think tank the Runnymede Trust said that very few people who feel they've been discriminated against will lodge official complaints. He said, "I don't think it's a surprise as there's very low levels of confidence in police, especially among Black and mixed race people. We have a system where complaints are made to the same system that protects officers. So we have very low accountability. That means there's a lot of suspicion and apprehension before people do file a complaint. Of the people that do complain, I'm not surprised by the number that achieve justice." Suresh Grover, the watchdog, the monitoring group, said, "People don't have any confidence in making complaints. If they do, they get really tired by the process. There are serious cases where people are racially attacked and they've gone to the police. And they've found the police themselves are discriminating against them. Police forces deny that the figures are a sign of systemic failings." Chief Constable Craig Guilford, lead for complaints and misconduct at the National Police Chiefs Council, said the variation between the proportion of upheld cases is expected. He said, "Whilst complaints of racism are extremely low in number, each one is still taken very seriously by our professional standards departments and the Independent Office for Police Conduct. Racism complaints are very low in number and vary from force to force. Consequently, the variation in the numbers upheld is to be expected." He rubbished allegations of institutional racism within UK police forces, saying, "The police service welcomes scrutiny and wherever there is evidence of misconduct, we will always take appropriate action. Equally, when an investigation finds no evidence, it is important that this is also reported." Thank you for listening. More info can be found at the following https://www.links.live/news/lancashire-news/lancashire-police-received-dozens-racism-199-79005. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to the Freedom Fighter channel for more great videos. Thank you.